We'll blow the horn.
Croker, over to you, Jason.
But now, the emotion's already there on this man.
Pretty good, you know. It was good to get to Canberra, where it sort of all started for me, and get the win. Most importantly, on a debutant and a few milestone games for the boys, it was special. Yeah, I didn't feel as weird as I thought it would be. I think because I'd been preparing the whole week for that moment to be back in Canberra and to get the job done. I think the boys were really excited about the challenge of going up against a form side in the Raiders, and on a night that meant so much to them. It was a special day, and for Jarrod, and I get along really well with him. So I won't lie, where, it was, I guess, a little bit daunting having to go to Canberra and do the job on them, I guess, spoil the party. And it's just rugby league. And, I had a really good chat to him after the game about, how proud he should be of himself to get to that position. And, he's been done nothing but overcome. And yeah, I was stoked for him. And for us too, because we got the 2 points. Lexus, and I'm skipping school days. Mic drops, eyes on summer like Cyclops. Yeah, we falling off the sidewalk. Mama wants a home for nightfall. Excited, man. It's good to be back in Canberra. Good to be back with the team and ready to get the business done tomorrow night. Yeah, it seems like we're back in Auckland. Seems like we've brought the weather over to Canberra with us. So that's nothing we're not used to. It's gonna be exciting. Last call. Jerry's line too long. Teenage mutant coming out of my shell. Hey. Yeah, this be that corner piece, cornerstone, 10-piece, corner stove, skin knees, cortisone, and X-Links, chromosomes, summer feet, cobblestone, mama leave, home alone, on my feet, Chuck E. Cheese, on my sleeve, cortisone, 99 Titans, close to my goals, yeah, look like Kevin Dyson, with my curfew getting closer, hand-me-downs, pick-me-ups, dark side, shouts rhyme, in my hood, call it buck. Yeah, I was, feeling pretty good. It was the same, I guess, feeling that I get before every other game, and that's how I wanted to approach it. It was a special game, not only for our boys, but we had a debutant as well, an NRL debutant. So the job was to get out and get the job done for them and for ourselves. And I guess, it was really exciting getting back into the GIO Stadium with a Warriors kit. It wasn't as weird as I thought it would be, I guess, because of the preparations throughout the whole week for that moment. It wasn't as, didn't have that novelty, I guess, that I thought it would have. So I guess the thing that was going through my head was, just to start the game well, make sure that our boys were ready, and I felt like the whole week we were.
Obviously, the main man for tomorrow, though, boys, is going to become warrior number 282, Ali Leotewa. To invite some special guests to come in and present you with your jersey, we've got mum and dad.
Thanks again, Ruby and staff, for giving me this opportunity. I'm just a little kid from Rotorua, just living out his dreams. Thanks for flying out my parents and my family, and just having them here means the world. They've been by my side all my life, dropping me off to trainings, to games. wasn't until a few months ago they stopped dropping me off to training up with you guys. Dropped me off to your pre-season. But for tomorrow, let's just go up there. Big game for Ed, Mars and Joshy. A few milestones out there, so I'll just go out there, get the job done, and play season.
Charnze Nicoll-Klokstad, last time you were here, you were bidding an emotional farewell to Canberra. What's it like first time back?
Yeah, it's a bit of a surreal feeling. You know, I've had this circuit on the calendar for a long time now, so to be back, ready to play, it's going to be a good buzz.
Yeah, that's the hardest part, isn't it? You can see Jarrod very emotional. The Warriors get the first bite at the Raiders. Here we go. One of the biggest nights here in years, and it's underway. How you like me now?
Yeah, it was a bit of a hard one. Webby, you know, pulled me aside at the start of the week and, you know, pretty much just said, you know, you have nothing to prove. And I sort of felt the same too. I felt like I left on good terms and, you know, I didn't feel like I needed to prove to anyone there, you know, I am where I am for a reason. And, you know, I've just been really enjoying my time with the Warriors. If anything, I needed to prove, you know, to my mates in our Warriors jersey that, you know, I was there to do a job for them and just made sure that I prepared as best as I could, as I have been every week so far this year, and put my best foot forward. Yeah, it's good being back home. We, as much as we loved being in Canberra and being back there for the weekend, you know, this is home for us. We're so settled in Auckland and really get along with all of the boys at the Warriors and their partners too. So we're really enjoying life here in Auckland. Got our boy, Rome, he's our dog, and got our two boys that are coming up to Auckland on Friday this weekend. So really good to be able to catch up with them and create more memories that we can look back on. I do feel like there's a bit of a buzz going around New Zealand at the moment, and it's exciting. You know, me and my wife talk about it all the time. You know, you got people that probably, you know, wouldn't support us as much, I guess, if the results were going the other way, but you'd rather them be the way that they're being than, you know, not supporting you at all. So it's good to see the community get around us and back us and really enjoy the brand of footy that we're playing, because we're definitely proud of the brand of footy we're playing as well. Breaking up the suit, yeah. Wake up on your futon. Why you in my crew neck? Wait.